Hello, and welcome to VGSTUDIO MAX, the industry's leading software for analysis and visualization of industrial CT data. In this video, we'll take a closer look at what's new in VGSTUDIO MAX 2023.1 and learn about the new features of our favorite software. One of the most significant changes in the new VGSTUDIO MAX is the introduction of a new ribbon interface. It replaces the old menu structure and makes it easier to access all the application's functionalities. Then there is machine learning-based segmentation, which is designed to learn from your input and optimize the segmentation process. Say goodbye to time-consuming and labor-intensive segmentation tasks. We also introduce a new battery inspection module that allows you to inspect any battery type accurately and efficiently and easily analyze the anode overhang of any battery. Beyond these three major highlights, you'll find a few enhancements to reconstruction, visualization, navigation, reporting, measurement, and automation. Many of them were inspired by you and your daily work with our software. Before we get into the details, this much in advance. If you're short on time or just want to get specific information on a particular topic, feel free to skip to the chapter of your choice in the video description below. And for those of you staying tuned, here we go. For the new version of VGSTUDIO MAX, VGSTUDIO, VGMetrology, and MyVGL, we have reworked the application user interface. We have switched to a so-called ribbon user interface to make application functions more easily accessible and to group them in a more logical way. We have also introduced features to streamline workflows and to make the application more customizable for power users, like a shortcut editor or a built-in editor to create customized ribbon tabs. When you open VGSTUDIO MAX 2023.1 for the very first time, the What's New page welcomes you, bundling everything worth knowing about the new features and functions of the current release. This also includes buttons at the top that take you to additional helpful content on the web, such as the latest release webinars, FAQs about the new menu structure, or dates for upgrade training. After that, every time you start VGSTUDIO MAX, this beautiful welcome page awaits you as the main starting point for your tasks in our software. This new full-screen file menu replaces the old file menu, and it provides access to the same basic functionalities for handling project, import and export of data, and to batch processing. Recently used projects are displayed as large and detailed individual thumbnails, allowing you to quickly pick up where you last left off. Of course, you can edit this list and delete single file entries or the whole history at once. We'll take a closer look at the other functions in a bit, but for now, we'll switch to the workspace area. Hit File to close the menu or select one of the other menu items at the top. In the newly designed workspace area, you see the ribbon bar on top. This replaces the old menu structure and the icon bars. Apart from that, the user interface has remained mostly unchanged. That means the viewports and the tool dock on the right are still available and provide access to the same functionality as before. Let's have a look at the ribbon tabs and start right away with the first and most exciting one, the Home tab. This tab is so special because it duplicates functionality from all the other tabs and provides access to it in a single location. That means it has direct access to all the features you need for your workflow. The content of the Home tab is determined by the workflow you select on the welcome page. There you can choose from four predefined workflows that gather commonly used functionality: visual inspection, porosity analysis, metrology, or material analysis. Whatever you choose, it only affects the Home tab. All other tabs remain unchanged. Let's have a quick look at the other tabs, the standard ribbon tabs. Edit contains all the functions from the old menu, as well as functions for converting between different object types and copying pasting visual states. Volume contains surface determination, filters, and functions for merging and projecting volumes. Select contains clipping, segmentation, and ROI functionality. The old registration methods have been renamed to alignment and are now collected in this tab. It also contains transformation functionality and the coordinate system editor. The geometry tab is all about geometry elements, and measurement is about measuring on them, but it also contains indicator, instruments, and related template functionality. CAD, surface mesh, is essentially the same as the old menu, as is analysis. Reporting replaces the old reporting tool and allows you to create, edit, and view reports using the built-in report editor. This tab also contains bookmarks and save image and movie functions, as well as functions related to the VGRF format, which we renamed from VGRF report to VGRF export. Animation replaces the old menu. and Window provides access to the Workspace Layout Editor and various methods for configuring the viewports in the workspace. You can also select which tools appear in the tool docs and the position of the docs themselves. The Help tab replicates the old Help menu. In addition to the standard ribbon tabs, there's also contextual properties tabs that are highlighted by a blue background and that show up in specific contexts. To access these tabs, you simply select them. For example, when selecting volume render objects, regions of interest, or mesh render objects, the highlighted visualization tab can provide quick access to the object's transparency or color settings. Or the clipping tab, providing access to the settings of a selected clipping object. And then there are contextual workflow tabs. These tabs appear and are automatically selected when certain actions are triggered. Like the instrument tab that appears when you start a measurement on a volume object using instruments. This allows you to control the settings of the instrument that you're currently creating and to immediately create another instrument of a different type when you're done with the first one. We'll see a few more of these workflow-related tabs later in the video. By the way, you can minimize and maximize the ribbon interface by simply double-clicking a tab or by using the context menu. When minimized, it automatically hides and appears only when a menu item is selected, and it automatically disappears when a dialogue or action is triggered. Perhaps the best thing about the new interface is that it's completely customizable, thanks to the powerful built-in editor that you'll find on the welcome page next to the four workflow presets. Not only can you hide groups from the ribbons or entire tabs, but you can also create entirely new tabs or groups and fill them with functionality available in the application. Even functionality that is not part of the original ribbon content itself. Get creative and find the perfect solution for your typical tasks. And speaking of customization, to satisfy your growing need for keyboard shortcuts, we've also a shortcut editor now that allows you to view and edit the shortcuts that come with the application. This can be used to modify existing shortcuts or to add shortcuts to any functionality available in the ribbon interface. Both shortcut and ribbon tab customizations are saved and restored when you restart the application. And of course, you can export, import, and share them with your fellow colleagues. And then there is one more thing. VGSTUDIO MAX now comes with a search function, making it easier to find specific functions quickly. No more searching through menus and icons. Just click the magnifying glass, enter your search term, and you're good to go. For us, the new interface marks the beginning of a new era in VGSTUDIO MAX user experience. That's why we sincerely hope that you will quickly see the benefits of this new approach in your workflow. And we can't wait to hear what you think of the new interface. Now it is all about machine learning-based segmentation. Segmentation tasks are often challenging, especially when using classical methods such as thresholding or region growing. But now we have a brand new segmentation tool for you that is based on machine learning and can be trained by simply painting the data. Say hello to Paint and Segment and let the machine do the work. The Paint and Segment tool has a wide range of applications including material science, life science, paleontology, and archaeology. For example, in battery inspection, it is a useful tool for segmenting anodes and cathodes to measure anode overhang. It can also be used to detect foreign particles in the jelly roll or to find flaws such as delamination or folded current collector foils. In material sciences, it can be used to separate and quantify fibers from matrix material, filler material, and pores in fiber-reinforced composites. It can segment low-contrast phases in metal matrix compounds or in ceramic matrix compounds, cracks in composite materials, and different kinds of porosity in additively manufactured parts such as gas pores and keyholing within one sample. And it is useful for segmenting bones and organs from tissues, for segmenting areas of different thickness or structure in shellfish, and for segmenting roots from soil and root growth experiments. To demonstrate the power of Paint and Segment, let us look at two examples. Sheet molding compound consists of glass fibers and a polymer matrix filled with chalk. This is a difficult material to segment using traditional methods. But with Paint and Segment, the three different regions, the filler, the fibers, and the matrix can be easily separated. Simply zoom in on specific areas and draw labels for each region of interest. Once you've drawn the labels, the tool can segment the data quickly and accurately. When it comes to quality inspection in battery manufacturing, Paint and segment can be used to segment anodes and cathodes for anode overhang measurement. Zoom in on specific areas and label each region of interest, such as background, cathode, and anode. Once you've drawn the labels, the tool segments the data quickly and accurately. You can refine the segmentation iteratively by simply drawing in the areas where it doesn't yet fit. In addition, you can save your created model and apply to other batteries in the future without having to repeat the labeling process. Plus, this function is also macro recordable, so you can use it for inline jobs within VGSTUDIO Max. Segmentation will never be the same again, thank goodness. Or to put it in the words of our developers, if it's a pain to segment, use Paint and Segment. Battery inspection is a critical step in ensuring the safety and reliability of battery systems, and our new tool can help you achieve that. With its anode overhang analysis feature, you can accurately and efficiently inspect any battery type. The tool is a 2D inspection of the anode overhang area of a battery that delivers various color overlays to indicate relevant parameters. You can export calculation results as a CSV file for further investigation or wrap it up with the reporting tool. The analysis is fully macro compatible and can be used in an inline scenario, making it convenient for quality control, testing, and maintenance of battery systems. The workflow for the new battery analysis is as follows. All you need to investigate the battery anode overhang is a segmentation of the anodes and the cathodes. This can be done with any segmentation method provided in VGSTUDIO Max. In this example, we use the new Paint and Segment tool to get there as quickly as possible. A preview of the segmentation shows all electrodes marked by a yellow rectangle at their tips. If they are not yet complete, you can repair particles and gaps in the segmentation until they are. For easy interpretation, the following inspection results of the anode overhang area can be visualized as color overlays. The left and right projected overhang. The left and right shape following overhang. The maximum curvature of the anode. The average thickness of the anode. The exit angle of the anodes. And the adjacent cathode count. Activate the shape following line to see the exact form of the anodes. This line is the foundation of the local curvature measurements. Speaking of curvature, you can visualize the local curvature of the anodes as a color overlay and use it as an indicator of a heavily bent anode. In the color overlay, the maximum curvature values are indicated with the yellow circle. Find all battery inspection results in the electrode and anode table, from where you can export them as a CSV file for further investigation. Or use the reporting tool to summarize and visualize the results as known from other VG analyses. Each result can be tolerated separately, and the tolerance state is then visible in the scene tree and in the reports. And to complete the package, the full battery anode overhang analysis is macro recordable and can be used in an inline job. The new battery inspection is a powerful tool for inspecting the anode overhang area of a battery. That makes it an essential tool for quality control testing and maintenance of battery systems. Now let's talk about you guys, you who use our software. Many of the following improvements are largely due to your great feedback. You help us in many ways with your ideas and suggestions. With the small and big changes that follow, we want to give something back to you and say thank you, and we want to encourage you to continue to share your experiences with us. When working with multiple objects in the scene tree, you can now toggle the visibility of these objects using a shortcut or context menu. This works for ROIs, for geometry elements, basically for anything that has a checkbox. Copy-paste visual state activates ROIs. The next improvement concerns copy and pasting visual states, and this is a feature that many of you seem to use a lot and enjoy very much. Now, when you paste a visual state into a target ROI, it will automatically be activated if it was not previously activated. Now on to a feature we know some of you have been waiting for a long time. The new active tripod. It appears in the 3D view when you unlock an object in the scene tree. The active tripod makes transformations easier and more intuitive. Just grab the handles to move or rotate an object. And when you want precision, just type in the numeric value you want, even as you drag the mouse. Because it feels so intuitive, we implemented this functionality in other places as well. For example, when creating a manual coordinate system, you can now choose Edit in Scene to make your adjustments directly on an active tripod and feed the values into the dialog. Or when creating or transforming geometry elements. It's never been easier than with the active tripod. We have improved the misalignment correction in the Reconstruction module. If a previous calculation method obviously gives wrong values and results in double structure, you can now run a tryout series. Simply define the number of steps per direction, the step size, and the quality of the calculation to compute a set of images. And by clicking the ideal point in the resulting image stack, you feed the value into the misalignment field. Repeat and refine the previous values until you're happy with what you see. The next feature will be about creating geometric tolerances for extracted median elements. Let's say we have these two opposing parallel planes, and we want to create a GD and T callout for this feature of size. According to ISO 1101, the toleranced element in this case should be the extracted median plane. To create such an element, we have introduced a new type of combined geometry element, the regular element. Based on the two source planes and according to the specified fit method, a parallel plane fit is performed to determine the associated median plane. A regular grid is created on this midplane, and for each grid point, point pairs are fitted on both sides, perpendicular to the associated midplane. The midpoints of all point pairs create the extracted median plane. Since the extracted median plane also contains the form error, it is possible to create not only orientation or position tolerances, but also a flatness tolerance. The deviations can be visualized, and automatic minimum and maximum annotations can be created. The deviation visualization of the extracted median plane is visible as long as the geometric tolerance is selected. It is not necessary to create a regular element beforehand, as you can see when you create a geometric tolerance for this cylinder. Here, the fitted axis is the default tolerance target. If you want to use the extracted median axis containing the former error instead, you can create it by clicking the regular element button next to the toleranced element. The saved default settings of a regular element are used for creation, but can be manually adjusted at any time by clicking the Edit Regular Element button. Instead of the automatic mode, which chooses a grid size based on the voxel resolution, we will now choose a fixed number of 5 circles and 720 points on each circle. The extracted median axis is automatically created by connecting the center points of all circles, which are also fitted with the specified pre-processing fit method. When the geometric tolerance is created, the regular element is created simultaneously and appears in the scene tree. In cases where the selected toleranced elements and tolerance type allow only for a meaningful measurement of the extracted median element, it will be created automatically, even without the need to click the button. Coming to the last item on our list, we have improved macro substitution logging to reduce confusion when playing back macros. For example, we changed harmless warning messages to info messages. Also, the log of the last macro run is now available in the automation tool. This helps you understand what the macro did and gives you more information about the objects it interacted with. And that concludes our What's New video. Thank you for joining us today to learn about the new features in VGSTUDIO MAX 2023.1. We hope you're as excited as we are. Don't hesitate to upgrade to the latest version and start enjoying all the benefits today.